Welcome to Empower In. My name is Caroline Porter Thomas. Thank you so much as usual for watching my YouTube channel and welcome to Anatomy 101. In this video, we're going to go over the vertebrae. We're going to go over the different parts of the vertebrae, including the transverse process, the foramen, the body, and the arch, and more. While you're watching the video, if you decide that you really like it, please do me a favor and give the video a thumbs up. Also, make sure you subscribe to the channel, hit the bell for notifications, and post a comment. By the way, this is the 9th video in this video series, Anatomy 101, so make sure you click the link above where you can view the entire series. All right, without any further ado, let's get right into the video. Parts of the vertebral spine. The typical vertebrae is made up of a vertebral body and a vertebral arch. Between the body and the arch is the vertebral foramen. All the foramina of each vertebrae line up to form the vertebral canal, which houses the spinal cord. There's also the vertebral body. This is the anterior part, or the front portion of the vertebrae. Its superior and inferior parts are lined with hyaline cartilage. Vertebral bodies in the spine have an intervertebral disc between them. The vertebral body is the main weight-bearing part of the vertebrae. Since this is the case, the vertebrae found in the lower portion of the spinal column have larger bodies than the vertebrae in the upper portion of the spine. The vertebral arch. If the vertebral body forms the front portion of the vertebrae, the vertebral arch forms the lateral or side and posterior or towards the back portions. Vertebral arches have various processes, which are bony prominences, where ligaments and muscles attach. Let's go over these, starting with the transverse processes. These extend at the sides and at the back of the vertebral body. Each of the vertebrae have two of these. We also have the spinous processes. The spinous process is found centered posteriorly at the vertebral arch's point. Each vertebrae has one spinous process. Articular processes. These form the joints between a vertebrae and the vertebrae on the top and under the vertebrae. Pedicles attach to the vertebral body to the transverse process, while laminae attach to the spinous process and transverse process. Facet joints, on the other hand, are the spinal joints, or the place where one vertebrae connects with the other. Intervertebral disc. Intervertebral discs are flat cushioning pads that lie between each vertebrae. They allow for flexibility and act as shock absorbers for motion. The intervertebral disc is made up of a tough outer layer called the annulus and a soft center called the nucleus pulposus. A herniated disc means that the intervertebral disc broke and that the center, the nucleus pulposus, seeped through the annulus. Types of vertebrae. The spinal column is composed of the cervical vertebrae, the thoracic vertebrae, the lumbar vertebrae, the sacrum, and the coccyx. The cervical vertebrae, or cervical spine. There are 7 cervical vertebrae in the body. They are known as C1 through C7. Among the 7 cervical vertebrae, C1 and C2 are called the atlas and the axis. They are unique and essential for head movement. C2 and C6 are small and oval in shape. All 7 cervical vertebrae have the following distinct features: a triangular vertebral foramen, a transverse process foramen transversarium, bifid spinous process, although exceptions to these are C7 and C1. Now let's go over the thoracic vertebrae, or the thoracic spine. There are 12 thoracic vertebrae. They are found in the chest section. The thoracic vertebrae is where the ribs attach to the spine. T1 has a transitional appearance, partly resembling the cervical vertebrae. T2 through T8 have a kidney-shaped appearance, while T11 and T12 also have a transitional appearance and partly resemble the lumbar vertebrae. Here are some characteristics of the thoracic vertebrae. Each thoracic vertebrae has two demifacets on the top and at the bottom of its vertebral body. These demifacets connect with heads of two different ribs. They each also have a transverse processes of the thoracic vertebrae from T1 to T10. They also have costal facets that attach to the tubercles of the ribs. Spinous processes of the thoracic vertebrae are long, slender, and sloping. The vertebral foramen of the thoracic vertebrae is circular. The lumbar vertebrae. The five lumbar vertebrae are the largest in the human body. They connect the thoracic vertebrae and the pelvis. Lumbar vertebrae are kidney-shaped and have short and thick pedicles and laminae. Their shape and large size are specialized for supporting the torso's weight. Unlike other vertebrae, the lumbar vertebrae do not have the following structures. They do not have a transverse foramina, a bifid spinous process, or costal facets. Similar to the cervical vertebrae, the lumbar vertebrae do have a triangular-shaped vertebral foramen. When it comes to their spinous processes, the lumbar vertebral spinous processes are shorter compared to the thoracic vertebrae. The spinous processes of the lumbar vertebrae also do not extend below the vertebral body. The lumbar vertebrae is usually where spinal procedures like lumbar punctures and epidural anesthesia are performed. The sacrum. The sacrum is composed of five fused vertebrae and forms the base of the spine and the back of the pelvis. Most clinicians describe the sacrum as an inverted triangle that can be felt at the small of the back. It has a dorsal and a pelvic structure, a base, an apex, and lateral mass on both sides. Congenital abnormalities related to the sacrum include lumbarization and sacralization. Lumbarization means the detachment of the S1 from the sacrum, while sacralization means the abnormal fusion of L5 to the sacrum. The coccyx. The coccyx is a small bone found below the sacrum. Just as there are no vertebral arches in the coccyx, there's also no vertebral canal in this structure. All right, guys, I really hope you liked that video going over the individual vertebrae. I hope you learned so much. Again, if you liked the video, please do me a favor and give the video a thumbs up. It really helps me out. Also, if you are studying anatomy and physiology, make sure you become a member of my channel because for only $5, you can have access to my best-selling program, How to Study for Anatomy and Physiology. This program teaches you exactly how I went from failing anatomy to acing it, and I've taught thousands of other students to do the same. So you definitely want to check that out. And make sure you stay tuned because in the next video, we're going to go over the thoracic cage. That video will be posted pretty shortly. All right, guys, I will see you soon. Love you. Bye.